seem to have run out of programs today. So I'll be more careful than I am usually to announce anything. Today's concert, today's class, rather, is dedicated to Joanna Pearson, wrap-up work. And I have given the class the name of Joanna Lover and Peter. Now, what I meant by that was that we have two works by Robert Schumann, Robert Schumann's lover and husband, but both of these were in different ways inspired by her, and I'll try to talk a little bit about that. And we have a work by Franz Liszt, arguably the greatest pianist that there has ever been, who allows Clara's at first admiration, and then jealousy, and then hatred. We can talk a little bit about that too. All right. We are starting with Rosa Lee, who is going to play the first book, the first of two books on was deeply inspired by two German writers of the early Romantic movement. One, whom we all know very well, E.T.A. Hoffmann, and the other, whom we don't read so much, named Richter, but his pen name was Jean-Paul. And it was particularly a novel of Jean-Paul's called Flegeljahre, which influenced many of Schumann's early works, a complicated novel involving two brothers named Wolf and Wolt, and they were certainly the originals for Schumann, Eusebius, and Florestan, and they're in love with the same girl, and at the end, there's a masked ball, very much like the masked balls that keep coming up in Schumann's early works, and one of them walks off and the other watches him leave. And that's the way Davidsbundler ends, though we'll have to hear the second book another time. Although it's Clara Wieck's mazurka that inspired Robert, the idea in the mazurka could have been written by himself. In other words, it was just the kind of idea that spoke to him most fully and most completely, and that was the aspiring upward interval.
Thank you.
very often does that. And I think, or at least I've convinced myself, that very often what he means by that is a feeling of forte, but not the first note, the white scale balance. So I want to hear. Davidsbundlertanze as an audition piece, assuming that he or she will be allowed to play the first few pages, and then the jury will move on to something else. The jury may say, would you start please with the number six? beautifully in such a case. Let's hear the next one. Let me ask you something. Now, I feel you're not letting me.